Hey, Anna, can I have a quick sidebar? I found it.
Where?
The goon squad won't let me near it.
Lynette isn't gonna be any better. They look after their own.
I can get there, but I'll need your help.
What exactly are you planning?
Distraction to get to Dickie. Setting the bear statue outside Kayla's tent on fire would work, but it's critical I wait for Anna to act first, or I won't have enough time. Then I can use a match to ignite the splinters and get the fire started. I'll have to get out of there before Lynette and Kayla can close in on me. After that, I'll hide in the cabin. Tyler and JR will leave to put the fire out. It'll give me a window of opportunity to run to Dickie's trailer unnoticed. Tyler will immediately run to his van to get the fire extinguisher. If he does get it, the fire won't burn for long. First step, the statue goes up in flames. This'll get everyone's attention. Lynette will go for her hose. She's right next to it. Definitely a problem. I have to reach the trailer before they put the fire out and notice I'm gone. Lynette will go for her hose. She's right next to it. Definitely a problem. That'll do it. No one will see me get to Dickie. I need to time everything carefully. I'll only get one shot. You'll have to be cautious. I need you to sabotage the water hose. Unscrew the cap where it attaches so there's no pressure.
Okay, but why?
Do you trust me?
Yes.
Then trust me. I've been looking for you. We need to talk.
Oh, no, look. I'm real sorry I clocked you and shit.
Clock me? You were the one that broke into Anna's house. You took something from Nick's computer. What was it? Where is it?
I didn't know what was gonna happen, man, I swear. I'm a nobody, all right? I'm just a guy trying to get by, that's all. I just want to take care of my moms and live life, man. And I've been trying to find a way out all my life. I just agreed to talk to him for just, like, a quote or something. I didn't know he was gonna put so much together. He was gonna pin us to the wall.
I don't have time. What did you steal?
His notes about his article, about the dealing and the drugs and names of dealers, and sellers, buyers, everything. I had to know what I was gonna be next. You've gotta believe me.
What'd you do with him? Where are they?
I don't have them, man. I left the stick at the dead drop up at Makeout Point. He'll pick it up soon, and then it's done. No proof, nothing.
Who's coming for it? Tell me who's coming for it.
My boss, Declan. His name is Declan.
Declan?
Yeah, the cop. You know him, everyone knows him. Oh man, I'm totally fucked now. When he hears I snitched again, I'm fucking done. But how was I supposed to know Nick was gonna stir shit up?
Are you saying he's involved in Nick's death? Tell me!
Come on! Just let me go! Please, I already told you everything! No, just let me go, all right? I really gotta leave town before he finds me! I'm begging you, man! Let me go! Let me go! Help! Anyone! Help me!
Shut up!
Hey, asswipe!
Should've known. Damn firebug.
I'm gonna kick the shit out of you.
Sam. Sam, we have to get out of here.
Shut up. Your ass ain't any better. You brought him here.
You've had this coming.
I can explain.
Oh, you'll explain, all right. Someone give me my rifle.
We're leaving.
God damn it, woman!
It doesn't make any sense. None of it does. Why would Declan do that? He was always a stand-up cop. Now he's a crime boss?
No time to think about it. Right now, we need to get to that dead drop. Nick probably gathered enough evidence to reveal what Declan was up to. Our word against his won't cut it. That stick is the only way we'll take him down.
Or maybe you could just stay out of this? Declan's trying to save his skin. If you go against him on that promontory, he'll be trapped in a corner. This isn't a game. This isn't a puzzle, and you're dealing with a man whose go-to solutions to problems has been to kill them away.
Is this why you told Joe you wouldn't keep Anna safe? To not feel guilty?
You can't bring Nick back, but you can still save yourself and Anna. Breathe. Focus. Think it through. Declan's already killed two people.
Sam, I know it's been a rough day, but you're freaking me out. Stop zoning out. We're just about there, and I need you to help me figure out our next steps.
Next steps? At a place where someone might put a bullet through your head. Nah, that's too dramatic. It'll probably be something quiet, simple. Make it look... Stop it!
I'm not doing anything.
Other than trying to save your life, you're not thinking clearly.
What are you looking at?
You're focused on finding the facts and not focused on the very real dangers.
You need to focus on the road, not on whatever daydream you're lost in.
Just stop. You're the one that needs to stop.
Sam, you're going too fast. You need to stop.
Leave me
Sam,
alone.
Sam, stop it. Sam! Sam!
Sam,
stop.
There's a turret!
Stop!
Stop! Sam! Stop! Stop! Stop the car! Sam, are you okay? You nearly got us killed.
I need a moment.
Take your moment, but make it quick. We're already at the promontory. We need to find that dead drop before Declan gets here.
We need to talk. Yes, Sam, it's time. What's happening?
Sam, I can't.
Where are you going? Get back here. I'm trying, but it's not working.
No!
Losing control of my own mind. Where are you?
Can you hear me? Can you even hear me?
Oh, fine. I'll come to you.
What? I got a feeling I'm not gonna like this.
Do not freak out. You've been through this before.
Again. Stick to the fundamentals. Breathe. Focus. You can make it out. It still keeps going. It feels like I'm trapped in a maze. Question is, where does it lead? I wish there'd been another way. There you are. You and I need to talk. What? What's happening? Facts, Sam. That's how you'll get through this. Losing control of my own mind again. I'm almost making it a habit. At least I'm not being chased this time, right? Wonder what's in store for me now. I'm back to square one. I'm always starting from the same position and looking at the same door. Maybe it's not about which door I go through so much as which door I choose. Always tackle a problem head on, of course. There's no running away from it.
fucking up everyone's lives. That's a real talent.
When my father lost his legs, nobody knew the mine wasn't following regulations. You were the only one who started asking questions.
It can, but it does give me less patience for people who sling mud my way. You think you know who Nick was? Mr. Perfect? Give me a break.
You have no idea.
No one in this town does.
I don't need that right now.
Cheers to Nick, a man that, unlike us, people actually liked.
Nick and I had moved in together. Started to get serious.
They both deserved to be happy. Is that...
Your mother told me what happened. I know she's always pushing you to make friends.
Yeah.
Well, she's just afraid you'll end up alone. She doesn't want you to be unhappy.
Is she happy?
Not always. I'm not always happy either. Being happy isn't everything. I'd say it's more important to find out who you want to be than to be happy. Here, I brought you something.
It's so clear. I can see all at once.
That's what gives it strength. It has nothing to hide. It can see itself for what it really is. And that lets it see everything. It's not a flaw. It's a gift. Like a superpower, you know? When the world is a storm, you stand calm at the center.
Now, I need to have a real talk with myself. Where are you?
You and me, Sam, we can do this. What? Which one are you?